The dish to Kirilenko. And a miss there on the triple. Detroit's got a disappointing 2-6 on three-point attempts here in the fourth. Here's Joseph. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
Kevin, he's missing shot after shot after shot from long range. With time running low, he'd be better off trying something else.
Roten, no good.
I'll tell you what, for what's really an elementary shot, he looked a little nervous on that release.
Shoots a three. They get the rebound. Another shot. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Singler playing well. 12 points, and when it comes to rebounding, he's had a nice night there, too.
Yeah, he's really been mixing it up in the middle, getting in there and doing a lot of the dirty work for them.
And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats for Detroit.
Forcing turnovers. You want to convert at the other end. That's what this club has done.
They've repeatedly gotten out on the break tonight as well and scored a lot of baskets in transition.
That's good from Singler.
You know, the Sixers have really undergone a complete reversal in recent years from a team with a very old-school, traditional front office to a team that's now focused on the science and analytics of winning basketball. And quite honestly, guys, we're seeing more and more teams embrace the analytics side of things.
Stolen by Joseph. Now Detroit moving it up. Joseph leading the charge, and Caldwell Pope gets the basket.
Now that is a quick bucket. Pretty good in transition.
That's right. That's exactly right. He loves when he gets the chance to get out and run. That's when he's at his best.
And for the Sixers, their new stat-driven decision-making permeates the organization from ownership, Steve, to the front office, all the way down to the coaching staff.
Well, it's where the league seems to be going, Kevin. They're trying to think further ahead and see opportunities for strategic advantages. But look, it's still a balance. You've got to have chemistry and coaching, and those numbers will come in play. But they can't be the be-all, end-all.
Here's Joseph.
What a throwdown there. Man! Boy, taking it hard to the rack for the big throwdown.
And give an unofficial assist, Clark, to his teammate for setting the screen that freed him up.
Yeah, good call, Kevin. That was really the key to the play.
It's tipped. Stolen by Monroe.
2 minutes. 2 minutes left before the quarter.
And so he draws the foul on the shot on trip to the line to shoot two.
That's his third personal foul. Shooting.
First one falls for him.
Two shots.
And Joseph drops them both.
You know, sports medicine, really a key part to keeping NBA players on the court. It's getting so advanced, as are most things when it comes to performance and performance enhancement. But I read recently that they've discovered a new knee ligament. You'd think they'd have it all mapped out by now, but apparently not. They continue to make new discoveries.
They get it back. And Embiid gets it to go.
Well, since we hit half number two, he's finally come around. The first half was not his best, obviously.
Monroe sets a screen for Joseph. 1:27 left in the fourth quarter. This one for three. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Embiid's got his 18th rebound here tonight, all over the place. And you look at the players around the league who've dealt with serious injuries over their careers, and then, Steve, been able to return. Such a great boost to the league.
Yeah, no doubt, especially, you know, injuries that would be career-ending. Now players can often return to near 100%. You know, you never want to go under the knife, but if it's that or hang them up for good, the choice is easy.
Here's what Philadelphia's going with right now. Sims is checked in. And Robert Covington subbed in for Andre Kirilenko. And the first one drops. The 76ers making a switch here.
Henry Sims.
He hits both from the stripe. Detroit leading by 16.
Well, tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. An impressive win for the Pistons.
The coaching staff must be happy that they controlled their turnovers so well in this game.
Yeah, I like the discipline, the self-control, and the patience, Kevin.
And so looking at their number, this will be win number 22 on the year.
Well, not only are they on their way to winning this game, but this will also give them a win in the season series.
huge motivation for him today. Beating a conference opponent 3 out of 4 times, that's no easy feat.
Beyond the actual result of this game, I think fans are going to look back and see this was just a monstrous performance for the professor. He affected the game so much with the way he was able to come up with steals and get extra possessions for his team.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be, and Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
24 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Passes to Dinwiddie. Now, here's Joseph. Over Carter Williams. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for him. And so Detroit takes this one by a big margin. And this one was such a lopsided victory.
They never let up. They were full throttle from the start.
And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Plenty of assists for you in this win tonight. Did you see something in their defense that you were able to exploit?
Yeah, I saw lots of things I could exploit out there. It's like every defense is a different test, but I got the answer sheet for each one of them. Seems unfair, but that's just the way it is. That's why I dropped so many dimes on the cast tonight.
Congratulations. Terrific job. Humble Kevin, even with a stellar effort.
Thank you, Doris. And now for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for joining us tonight in our presentation of NBA on 2K Sports. Now our Jordan Player of the Game.
Head up, dog. We won, remember?
No thanks to me.
More like in spite of you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Means you couldn't hit water falling out of freaking boat tonight. Relax, man. Everyone in this league has an off night. Can't let it get to you. Question is, what are you gonna do about it? Work harder or pout like a punk? Point your fingers?
I point fingers when they need to be pointed. I need the ball in rhythm, in my spots. How am I supposed to have a good shooting night when you out there hogging?
Not even gonna answer that. What I do know is, when you point fingers at someone, there's gonna be 3 pointed back at you.